Number three, transmit password.
Access denied.
Transmit again.
Access denied. Access denied.
It's too much, Cap'n. They must have at least 41 flavors. Number three, what are you typing?
Yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen, it is now time to cap off the finale championship race weekend here at Auto Club with our fourth ever Hershey's Cup Series season finale, in which we will be determining whether or not we will have our fourth different Hershey's Cup Series champion, or maybe our first ever two-time Hershey's Cup Series champion, as Anthony McCrory, who won the very first championship in this series, is looking to pick up his unprecedented second championship in only four seasons. But he's going to have to get through three other drivers who are in their very first Final Four. Now, these three have taken part in chases before. Sanford was in the chase for the championship back in Season 2. He was actually in the Final Four back in Season 2, lost out to Chris Dodd. And Matt Haas and Blaine Keyes both made the chase for the championship last season as well as this season. However, both of them are making their first appearance in a Final Four format here at Auto Club. It's going to be just like it was in yesterday's Pizza Hut X Series race. Stage points will come into play, and whoever finishes the highest in the point stands with the most accumulated points at the end of the day will be the champion in the Hershey's Cup Series. But we've got some very interesting top stories to follow here. Just like we had that battle for like 25th in yesterday's race, none of your four chasers coming into this race qualified well. The highest starting chaser of the Final Four is Charles Sanford, last week's winner at Dega. He's rolling off from the 30th position. Anthony McCrory starting 33rd, Matt Haas 34th, and Blaine Keyes in 40th. They've got a lot of work to do. Let's get the command.
Drivers, start your engines!
There's the command to fire them up, and boy, it's easier, I think, maybe with the CTS physics for them to work their way up closer to the front of the field before we end up having our stages end, but I don't know. It's going to be crazy. Speaking of stages, we're going to be doing three stages today. 15 laps for the first two stages. The final stage will be 20 laps in length. 15, 15, 20, accumulating to our 50 scheduled laps here today. Sean Galligan lining up on the pole position in this one. Galligan looking for his second win of the season, trying to just cap off the season with a victory, as is JT Bryant, as is Trent Dunham. They all were in the chase but got eliminated, not partaking in the battle for the championship. And Kyle Matthews rolling off there for fourth. He is the defending champion, but he won't be able to be called that when the checker flag waves here today. The Season 3 champ looking for his third win of the season. And then you've got Zachary Fitzwater, who went to victory lane a few weeks ago at Homestead, Miami, looking for his second win of the season. But a lot of drivers behind them that are still looking for their first win of the season. You got Brandon Gonzalez, Tim Walsh, Dylan Young. They're all looking to battle each other, especially the fact that we're going to have that battle between Tim Walsh and Dylan Young coming down here into the season finale to see who's going to be in the top 30 in points when they leave here today, getting that charter into Hershey's Cup Series next season. Dylan Young comes into this race 1 point ahead of Tim Walsh. He's 30th in points. Walsh is 31st. That is going to be a battle to watch during the course of today's race. You'll also notice that the seven drivers that finished top seven in the non-charter finale a couple days ago They're interspersed through this field. They are not being put back to 36th through 42nd in today's starting grid. So you see Steven Gonzalez up here near the front. We'll see what he can do with some good track position to start this race. Green flag is out. The season finale at Auto Club is underway. And of course, we will be doing our best here to try and document everything that goes up here at the front of the field, as well as near the back where those four chasers started this race. Galligan to the race lead. Trent Dunham gonna follow in his tire tracks. Dunham going to victory lane at the very beginning of the season at Rio de Janeiro. As mentioned, for his second win of the season, he's gonna get passed for second place now by Zachary Fitzwater, and Sean Galligan went to victory lane this season at, where was it? Trying to remember, and I can't think of it. Nope, not pulling it in. Anyway, Galligan out in front, showing the way here in that 44 car. Wait, was Galligan in the chase? To remember. Yeah, Galligan was in the chase, but I don't have him listed as winning a race. I messed up on something on my writing something down. I don't know. Three wide for the race lead, though, here as we are only on the third lap of this race. Dunham up the middle, Galligan stuck on the high side, Fitzwater to the bottom. I've got Galligan with a win on my score four, but I don't have it with a win on my website where I use most of my statistics. So I goofed somewhere between transferring stuff from the score four to the website, and I'm not certain where I did it. Meanwhile, up front, as I'm looking away from the action, and there's four wide going on all through this field, Brandon Gonzalez is going to take a turn out in front, so now it's time to jump to the back. Wow, Steven Gonzalez started up near the front, now he's dropped way all the way to the tail end of the field. There's Charles Sanford. This is his home track, and he was in this kind of position two seasons ago in front of his home crowd trying to win a championship. He might be just playing it safe back here. That might not be bad strategy. Got to go up a little bit of a ways before you find Matt Haas there. He's stuck on the outside line, that 78 car. His brother Michael had a good run in the Pizza Hut X Series race here yesterday, so maybe he was able to give Matt some tips. Move further up. The next highest running chase driver is right there, Blaine Keyes. And this is actually a battle right now between himself and Murray for highest running chaser on the track, and he will take the position, Will Blaine. Their championship, first of their career. So far, this Hershey's Cup Series has had three different champions for three different teams. It was season one, Anthony McCrory winning for, at the time, Kyotech Racing, before he was brought over to Seth Colbaker Motorsports. Chris Dodd won the second championship for CJ Racing, and of course last season, Retro Racing Enterprises getting the championship with Kyle Matthews. Blaine Keyes right now has got a bit of a gap between himself and McCrory, so right now Blaine Keyes in good shape, and of course his goal is to try and get up here inside the top 10 so we can start getting some stage points to help grow that points lead between himself and the other three. Meanwhile, up front, they are racing tooth and nail. Fitzwater, Benjamin Miles, Garrett Sitter. Here comes Joshua Michaels to the inside. Joshua Michaels has won at this track back in season two. He won the season finale. And he's looking for his first multi-win season. He has three victories now, but only one win per season back in seasons one, where he won at Pocono, season two, where he won at Auto Club, and this season, of course, where he won at Oswego. Miles out in front now in the 25. Now, Benjamin Miles has not won at this track. However, he does have a flair for winning at the end of the season. He actually won week before Joshua Michaels won the Auto Club season finale in season two. Miles won the race at Talladega the week before. just to make sure. I'm going to look down at the bottom of the list, just make sure nobody's retired due to mechanical problems, and nobody has. The reason I'm doing that is because we had three retirees during the course of this weekend. Two, I believe, in the Hershey Cup Series non-charter race, and one in the Pizza.X Series race for tire problems, which was rather surprising that we had three drivers out of the race in 2 days for the same reason, a tire issue, which I don't think is something we have seen all season long. Garrett Sindor trying to take the spot away from Benjamin Miles, and as I said, the non-charter drivers that raced their way into this event were just sporadically dispersed through this field, so they didn't all start 36th after 42nd, and you can see as a result, Sean Henley there at number 57. He is there up in the top five now. You gotta wonder if, what Twinix Racing's gonna do next season. Steven Gonzalez driving here today, and what could potentially be his final Hershey's Cup Series start. He ended up making it up inside the top five in the point standings for the finish of the non-charter series, so that charter now is in the possession of Twinix Racing. Maybe Sean Henley will be a charter ride next season. I mean, think about it. When James McLeod ended up getting a charter for this season for Hershey's Cup, what happened? He ended up going to victory lane twice, made the chase for the championship in his first full-time charter season. So maybe the same could happen to Sean Henley if they decide to put the charter that Steven Gonzalez got this season on the 57 for next year. Right now, your champion, if the race were to end, is Blaine Keyes, and he is steadily working his way into the top 10. There he is. He might be in the top 10 this lap as he's trying to get by Sean Galligan. Not quite. He's about the 14th position right now. But the thing that's so important about where he is where we are in this race. You notice that next time by, there'll be four laps to go in this stage. And if Blaine Keyes gets himself up here into the top 10 at the completion of this first stage, he could be the only one of the four drivers that's going to get himself a spot in the stage point bonus points grid, depending on where he's at. Anthony McCurry is still the second highest running chaser. He's kind of back here in this second group. And you go back a little bit further, and that's Matt Haas and Charles Samper is all by his lonesome as far as chase driver's concerned. He's in a pack here with a few former winners this season. Emmanuel Hartnett, Levi McIntyre, and Cody Lamas. Carson Gumm leading that group. Joseph Srigley, who looks like he will not have a charter for next season as he's running way down the road stands and mathematically came into this race ineligible from even racing his way into the top 30. He's lost the draft, as has Steven Gonzalez and John Arndt. Boy, the wheels have fallen off the momentum train he had at the midway point of the season. Sean Henley led that lap, and they're going to go three wide into turn one. Four wide there for a moment. And right in the middle of all of this is Blaine Keyes. Starting to see Anthony McCurry in that second group try and catch up, and this is what McCurry needs. He wants that momentum to get up there, get ahead of Blaine Keyes, maybe get into the top 10, and if he can get into the top 10 and get more stage points than Blaine Keyes, that certainly would help his case. He's only going to have a couple of laps left to do it. Right now, Blaine Keyes is still inside the top 10. He was scored ninth last time by. Whoa, and he almost got turned off the nose of Nathan Hudson, who tried making it four wide there. Keyes puts it way down to the bottom of the racetrack. Blaine Keyes is fighting. This is the third chase he has been a part of. He was in the chase back in season one when he drove the number 48. He was in the chase last season as well when he drove the number 8 for Sega Motorsports, and now his third chase for the championship. But like I said, first time he's ever been in the final four. Think about how he had to get into the chase. Last minute shot clock cheese win, if you will. Getting pushed into victory at M&M Super Speedway to get himself into the chase for the championship. And it's been a very strong chase for him, no doubt about it. Next time by is the end of stage one. Anthony McCurry's got to be hoping and praying someone's going to stick Blaine Keyes in the middle or have him drop back or something outside of the top 10. He's in seventh. He'd have to lose three spots before we get back to the start-finish line. And with his car on the bottom, I don't think that's going to happen. He's going to go for more real estate. Now he's going to go three wide to the bottom on Caitlin Tseng. every position is a point as far as stage points go. And Blaine Keyes could find himself up as high as fifth place. We can get a good run here off of turn four. Drag race with Caitlin Tsang. He's trying it, and he's going to lose a couple spots, actually, on the bottom. He crosses the line in seventh, but as you can see, trouble! Caitlin Tsang around, and a chaser was involved, I believe. I think I saw Matt Haas involved, and there's multiple cars in it. Big, big wreck here at Auto Club that could have huge championship repercussions. Caution out just at the completion of the first stage. They must have been all racing to try and get stage points, and maybe that's what triggered the wreck, but it happened behind Blaine Keyes. And the caution is out. They'll race it back to the line. They were past the start finish line when the caution came out. Sean Henley gonna lead them back to the yellow flag, but that was a big wreck up there in turn number one. So Blaine Keyes was ahead of it, but I thought I saw Matt Haas possibly collected up in it. Not certain. Now we have to find out, did any of our four chasers get any damage from that? There's Sean Galligan, he was in it. So was Dylan Pote, Zach Flickinger, Chris Dodd, Caleb Farrell, Benjamin Miles. No chasers yet. Zachary Fitz, Waterly, and Alvarez, Nathan Hudson, Cody Lamas, Tim Walsh. Wow. Did all of our four chasers get through? Oh, they're stacking up. Don't do that. Please don't do that. Please don't do that. Please don't do that. Matt Haas got through it. And so did McCrory. Wow. That is a shocker that all four of our championship competitors after that big wreck in one are still running and appear to have not gotten involved in that wreck. Pit stops will take place here under caution. It's the first time we've had pit stops under caution this weekend, as both the Hershey Cup Series non-charter series and Pizza Hut X Series races had green flag pit stops. As Sean Henley leads them down, let's take a look at a replay of what happened. This was four wide coming to the completion of our first stage. And Caitlin Tsang, our Eldora race winner, I think she may run Garrett Sidner out of room. See her car drifting up, drifting up, drifting up, and there's just nowhere Garrett can go. There's only Walt to his right. And there goes Caitlin Tsang off the nose of Sidner. They come down. Benjamin Miles gets involved. Nathan Hudson is clipped. Trent Dunham gets involved, and then they all just start sweeping up. Nowhere for Fitzwater to go. Farrell, Sean Galligan right there. Zach Flickinger gets involved. Tim Walsh right there. Oh, and then there's Chris Dodd. Oh, and he flips over his future teammate. There's Pote Navarro. Look at the 78 of Matt Haas get to the inside there of the flipping Tim Walsh machine. Brooke Allen's involved. Wow, it's a wild ride for Tim Walsh. And oh, no, Alvarez comes flying in, and it's going to be Nathan Hudson that he gets. He goes sliding by. And then back here, we saw McCrory avoid. We saw Matt Haas avoid. And here's Charles Sanford. In the 03, track littered ahead of him, and he's going to get down to the apron and avoid it all. Wow, that was close. He nearly got Tim Walsh, and then again, almost gets Leon Alvarez, and Cody Lamas going to nail the 08. Wow. Well, that right there may have iced it as far as the battle for who's going to get the final charter for next season. Tim Walsh taking that wild ride. And he was 1 point behind Dylan Young. Dylan Young's still running. Tim Walsh is going to probably be out of this race. So it's looking very much like Tim Walsh will not have a charter for next season. So probably what I'm thinking is Chris Dodd's going to use the championship provisional to have spot in the races next year and probably give the charter to the 15, so that way Tim Walsh will be able to be in the series as well, because Tim Walsh making the move over to CJ Racing for next season. But nonetheless, all four of our championship competitors got through the wreck and were not involved, so they're still in the hunt and we're getting ready to go back green. Sean Henley's team gets it done on pit road. He will restart as the race leader, and when we go back green, we'll have 30 laps remaining in this one. He will have Caleb Farrell ahead of him, though. Farrell made a pit stop, came out ahead of race leader Sean Henley, but not ahead of the pace car. So therefore, he is between the pace car and Henley for the start. He's on the tail end of the lead lap in the 32nd position. It'll be Henley, Michaels, Gonzalez, then Blaine Keyes will restart in fourth. Keyes was the only one of the four championship competitors that got stage points on that last stage, getting, I think it was a total of 4 points. And Keith Batson will be fifth on the restart. Dylan Young looks like he'll get that final and 35th charter heading into next season. With Jake Baskinger, James McLeod, JT Bryant, the top nine, and Anthony McCrory's team gets it done on pit road. He's now going to restart in the top 10, so the battle may be on between the 42 and the 61 in the next few laps. What about the rest of your other two champs competitors? Matt Haas will restart in 17th, Charles Sanford in 19th. Just like that, all four drivers who didn't start any higher than 30th in this race are all up inside the top 20 for this restart, 20 laps in. Green flag back out here at Auto Club. Sean Henley trying to get by Caleb Farrell. Now he couldn't make the pass to the bottom before we crossed the start finish line. Now he's going to be able to lane change. Michael's not able to do the same because Brandon Gonzalez got his nose to the bottom, and Henley is going to set sail for turn one. Here comes the 61, four wide on the bottom. And now he's alongside Blaine Keyes, who's losing spots because he was stuck behind Caleb Farrell. His line was stuck behind the 95. And now McCrory checks out. So for McCrory, what McCrory needs to do is he's going to have to finish five positions ahead of Blaine Keyes unless he's able to get some stage points. And, oh, we got some cars down on the apron here. Russell Strigley and Steven Gonzalez running right down on the bottom of the racetrack. Charles Sanford has gotten up there clear of the Caleb Farrell machine. He's now the third highest running chase driver. Matt Haas has now also cleared the 95, but he had a little bit more difficulty getting around Farrell than the other three did. There's Sanford there with his teammate Kyle Matthews. There's another car down the bottom there. That is Carson Gumm coming back onto the racetrack. Unscheduled pit stop for the 85. Certain what was up with him. Blaine Keyes going to try and get back around Anthony McCrory. This is a battle for the eighth position. Carson Gumm appears to be back up to speed, so not exactly certain what he had to make the pit stop for, but it now has him a lap down along with Caleb Farrell, and the drivers out of the race after that wreck were Zachary Fitzwater, Benjamin Miles, Zach Flickinger, as well as Dylan Pote, Sean Galvier, and Thomas Nathan Hudson. Tough way for him to end the season. Tim Walsh out in 40th, Chris Dodd 41st, and Leon Alvarez there in 42nd. And McCrory is dropping back. He's lost a few spots now to Strigley, Young, and Bryant. He's got stuck in a three-wide situation. Blaine Keyes racing for the completion of lap number 30. He's already got four stage points in the bank. Looking for more. Charles Sanford now in a battle with Matt Haas. They are side by side. That is for the 17th position, just behind Kyle Matthews. Don't count these guys out. They're still coming up through the field. We also should mention as well that Charles Sanford, I forgot to mention this, with Sanford's win last week at Talladega that got him into the final four, he is 3 points up on everybody else with those 3 bonus points, those 3 win bonus points coming into this race. So we have to calculate those into the equation as well as Matt Haas fighting his way up towards the front. He's now going to go to the inside of Anthony McCrory. So now Matt Haas is the second highest running chase driver in the field. Blaine Keyes, though, has good strategy. Blaine Keyes is keeping his car down at the bottom. He's not allowing anybody to get to his inside, force him into the middle or the high side. And as soon as I say that, here comes Jake Baskinger, going to force him in the middle. You don't want to be on the middle to high line in the corners because you're going to lose spots. Blaine trying to get it back down to the bottom, but now he's got two more drivers to his inside. Make it three. Contact there between Joseph Strigley and Dylan Young. Close call up inside the top 10. And here you see that 78, that black Toyota Camry looming large there. He's almost cracked the top 10. He's only a few spots back from Blaine Keyes. Anthony McCrory is going the wrong direction. He is dropping back. Was up inside the top 10 on that restart. He's now falling back to 16th. He's about to lose a spot to Charles Sanford. That battle's going on. He did lose the spot. Sanford now moves up the spot to the, I think that's the 15th position. Nope, 16th. McCrory drops back to 17th. McCurry's been here before, though. There could be some strategy. Because I think these drivers are going to have to make at least one more stop before this race is over. They went to pit road on, I think it was lap 16, lap 17. And they can only make it about, 17 to 19 laps on fuel. So they cannot make it the whole rest of the way without having to come to pit road again. Meanwhile, we got a new driver up front. Jake Baskin is on the point in the number 5, looking to cap off a great season. Only driver to ever be in all 4 chases for the championship here in the Hershey's Cup Series. Looking for his second win of the season, and it looks like they're going to catch the 95 of Caleb Farrell, who's already a lap down, and we know he's very much off the pace. This could get extremely interesting depending on where they catch him. Henley is in second. There's Dallas McIntosh, the only one of the Sega Motorsports cars not to go to victory lane yet this season. Chaser last year, 2-time winner last year, and he's going to get caught behind Caleb Farrell through 3 and 4. And so is his teammate, and here comes Matt Haas in the 78 to the bottom for the position on Blaine Keyes, side by side between the 2 top chasers in the field. And there's Charles Sanford waiting to catch this lead pack, and he very well might now, as they still are having some difficulty back there getting around Caleb Farrell. And Blaine Keyes now drops a few spots behind Matt Haas. So Haas to the point. Now Matt Haas is in the situation where he needs to finish at least 5 spots ahead of Blaine Keyes. Keep in mind too, if we have a tie for the championship points, it will come down to who has the most wins. Matt Haas is the one that has the most wins between himself and Blaine Keyes. Keyes has 1, Haas has 2. Sanford also has 2, so he would be the only one that'd be able to put it into a further tiebreaker between himself and the 78. They would then have to go to most top 5s this season, which, looking at it here, Sanford has 3, Haas has 9. So Haas would win the championship off that tiebreaker. Meanwhile, back up front, top 2 have broken away. Baskinger checking out. And they're going to complete lap 30. Matt Haas is going to get himself a lot of bonus points, 8 in total here for this stage. Blaine Keyes was inside the top 10. He'll get 1 bonus point. So 8 stage points for Haas, 5 stage points at this point in time for Blaine Keyes. Curry and Sanford still looking for their first. There's Sanford battling with JT Bryant. He's now worked his way up. He's still in the 16th position. Anthony McCrory all the way back in 24th. So unless something really drastic happens for him, that may be his hopes of winning his second championship done. Now the question is, when do the drivers decide to come to pit road? Pit road's rather treacherous, and this pit road could maybe play a factor into who's going to win this championship as well, these green flag pit stops. Baskinger, Henley, and then Matt Haas up there in the 3rd position. Right now, based on the points and the stage points calculated, would be the champion. Blaine Keyes right there, still inside the top 10. Here's Dylan Young. The 2 car looking for his first win of the season, trying to make it a sweep for the Young Motorsports Fords. Levi McIntyre going to victory lane at Lime Rock, JT Bryant at Dover, and Dylan Young trying to get his first win since Homestead, Miami in season 2. Joseph Srigley right there in the 24, a 2-time winner last season, has a win this year. We already documented Dallas McIntosh. He would also be trying to do the sweep for the Sega Motorsports. Trent Dunn going to victory lane at Rio de Janeiro. Blaine Keyes going to victory lane at M&M Super Speedway. 3 wide up here, and that sticks Matt Haas to the outside line. Should get that good run off the corner, but he will not clear Dylan Young. And now he's up in the wall. He is scraping the wall pretty badly, and that car is going to lose a lot of position. He loses a spot to Strickland, McIntosh, Michaels, and now maybe we'll lose one to Jessica Shelton. Meanwhile, no forward progress on the part of Charles Sanford. Matter of fact, he may have lost a couple more spots. He's up in the wall now and getting freight trained by Hartnett, Dunham, Brooke Allen, and Steven Gonzalez. So Sanford might be out of this championship hunt unless they can roll some kind of pit strategy. Remember, it was Sanford getting into the Final Four last week at Dega because of pit strategy. He may try and do it again. Another slow car for the leader, Jake Baskinger, to deal with. That will be Angel Navarro in the 98. Navarro, it looks like he might be up to speed. He just isn't in the draft. Now Baskinger will take care of him. Next driver will be second place Sean Henley. Henley putting on a good showing here in that 57 car. This is Henley's... his fifth start of the season in a charter race. Average finishing position in those five races, 38th place. This is certainly a lot better than what he's had in the races that he's made. He's now third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh will make their way around Angel Navarro's now lap machine. And at the moment, it is all Matt Haas up in front. With him running where he is, and with Lane Keyes running where he is, they would have a separation of 6 points on track and a separation of 4 points in stage points. So that's about 10 points advantage Matt Haas has right now in the live point standings over Lane Keyes. While that'll maybe on for second. Still way out in front, but Sean Henley is starting to get reeled in by Dylan Young, Joseph Srigley, Matt Haas, and Dallas McIntosh. Another car up ahead, that's Caleb Farrell again, that Baskinger is going to be catching momentarily. And I thought maybe he was coming to pit road. It sounded like he got out of the throttle going there in the corner. There's Matt Haas, still determined to get up there into a podium position. Right now, it seems like his only source of competition would be Blaine Keyes, but Blaine Keyes is on pit road. So he's short pitting here. He's one of the first one down. This might not be bad strategy, too, on his part. Get fresher rubber, be able to turn faster lap times. He may gain some track position on Matt Haas. And he is the only one that came to pit road there. So apparently, maybe a championship-weighing decision, trying to roll the dice, be a little off-sequence with everybody else. Anybody else coming to pit road this time? Doesn't look like it from that group. What about this group? Nope. So Blaine Keyes, the only one deciding to pit here. Short pit, it appears. Here he is coming off pit road. This will be very interesting to see how this strategy works out for the 42. Meanwhile, battle on for third. Dylan Young, Matt Haas, and Joseph Srigley, they have been going at it for the last 5 to 7 laps, and they're going to catch the car of Caleb Farrell again. Farrell almost came down and wrecked Matt Haas. But Haas now, utilizing that, is going to jump to second place. He even caught Sean Henley, and he's going to get around him to get up to the runner-up spot. 11 laps to go. These drivers are going to have to pit. The only driver that will not have to pit at this point is Blaine Keyes. And he's on pressure rubber. Pressure rubber means more grip. More grip means faster lap time. So right now, Blaine Keyes is making up more ground speed-wise than Matt Haas is. We'll have to take a look here this time by. We'll take a look at the lap time speeds to try and figure out the difference. As it looks like maybe Sean Henley might be coming to pit road. Yes, he is. He'll give up the fourth spot. This time by, Matt Haas' lap time is a 40.983. Let's find Blaine Keyes. As Sanford's on pit road. So that's one of our championship competitors. There's Blaine Keyes. So a 40.9, and Keyes ran a 41.3. Oh, wow, so that was actually slower. Maybe because he was in draft. There's Sanford, trying to have something good happen here with this pit strategy, perhaps. Here comes Jake Baskinger giving up the race lead. Srigley's in, Matt Haas also coming to pit road. That turns the race lead over to the Cheez-It Chevrolet of Dallas McIntosh. Where is this all going to cycle everybody when the pit stops are over? I don't think McIntosh can make it the entire rest of the way. He has to make it 8.5 laps. I just don't see that possible. They went back green with 30 laps to go. So there is no way he could have made 30 laps on one tank of fuel, and he's coming to pit road this time. That could turn the lead over maybe to this guy, Sean Henley. He was in around the third, fourth position when he came to pit road. We have to see where he comes out in relation to Matt Haas and Jake Baskinger. Keyes appears to have picked up some ground there in that 42 car. Not too far back there, you can see him. And he is going to catch, it looks like, Matt Haas. So the battle between those two is going to be back on, as Baskinger will come out with the lead, Swigley second, Henley third, Michaels in fourth, and look at this. There's Matt Haas, and right behind him, now to his outside, is Blaine Keyes. So that short pit strategy worked for the 42. And he will drive around Matt Haas. And now sets his sights on Dylan Young. So right now, Blaine Keyes has cut down the points advantage between himself and Haas down to 9, and now he's looking to cut it down to 8, trying to get around Dylan Young. This could come down really close. Oh, troubles for Jessica Shelton! The 02 is on the apron. She was running up inside, running in the race lead. What happened there? I think she's back up to speed. What happened with her? They had her scored as the race leader. Oh, now she's coming to pit road. Did she stay out? No, she... I don't know what happened there. I don't know if the car stalled on her or what. She was scored last time by as the race leader, and now has dropped back to about the... It's like the 11th position. I don't know what was up right there with the Tampa Bay Race Chevrolet. Whatever the case, though. Tough break in the closing stages of this race, and this is the battle right here between Keyes and Haas. What Blaine Keyes would have loved is if Matt Haas would not be inside the top 10, so he couldn't get any stage points, and Blaine Keyes would be the only one to get stage points. But in order for that to happen, Jessica Shelton and Brandon Gonzalez have to catch back up here. With Shelton being up inside the top 10, that was a possibility. Meanwhile, it is Jake Baskinger setting sail. He has over 4 seconds in hand back to Joseph Swigley. Only Jake Baskinger can ruin his chances of winning today's race. And Baskinger trying to pick up his second win of the season, fourth win of the season for Arndt, or for AS Racing, I should say. Battle is on for second. Swigley has it. Keith Batts in there along with Henley, Dallas McIntosh, Dylan Young, Kat Tellier, Joshua Michaels, and then you've got the battle between Matt Haas and Blaine Keyes. This is, I think, the only race this weekend where stage points may play a factor in the outcome of who's going to be our champion. None of our four championship competitors yesterday in the Pizza Next Series race end up getting any stage points whatsoever. It just came down to who was the highest running finisher. But here today, two of our championship competitors got stage points. Matt Haas had 8 after the completion of stage 2. Blaine Keyes finished in the top 10 in the first stage, and he ended up getting 3 bonus points. I think it was 3. No, 4 bonus points. I apologize. And Matt Haas making a move on Joshua Michaels, so that's another point he gained on Blaine Keyes. Now Matt Haas would have a 6-point advantage over Blaine Keyes. And now maybe make it 7 as he tries to get around Sean Henley. And the thing that is not on Blaine Keyes' side is time. Oh, wait a minute, slow car, Caleb Farrell. Will he play an outcome in this? Who's he gonna hold up? He's holding up that outside line. The only car caught up there is Dallas McIntosh, and here comes Blaine Keyes with a big wave of momentum, trying to get up to the 78. He will get to the inside. He almost wrecked him. Almost got him in the left rear quarter pin. They will drag race down the straightaway here. Couple of cars up ahead. Garrett Sinder, Cody Smart, our winner here a couple days ago in the non-charter race. Levi McIntyre, but I don't know if they're going to be caught. They may get caught by Jake Baskinger before the race is over, but I don't think they'll be caught by this group. And Matt Haas still hangs on to the position over Blaine Keyes. Now looks for seventh place off Joshua Michaels. Dylan Young now moves to second. Here comes Keith Batson. It's the Lincoln teammates. Batson and Tellier trying to finish out the season strong, but both have not found victory lane yet this season. Lincoln still with a zero in the win column, but both trying to get top five finishes here today. As Jake Baskinger, what a dominating performance for the Auto Trader Chevrolet. The white flag will be displayed for him this time by. Looking for his second win of the season. And I believe it would be his second multi-win season. His first was back in season one, if I remember correctly, when he went to victory lane twice in the number 95. I think he only went to victory lane once in season two and once in season three. Over 4 seconds in hand, he could coast and still beat the drivers behind him. Out of turn four for the final time, heading for home, Jake Baskinger is going to pick up his second win of the season. He'll win the season finale here today at Auto Club. And here comes the 78 of Matt Haas. He is your season four Hershey's Cup Series champion. It was announced just a couple days ago that Matt Haas re-signed. Oh, troubles for Garrett Sinder at the close of this race. Matt Haas re-signed with Furniture Row Racing for three more seasons. He will come into season five in that number 78 as your defending Hershey's Cup Series champion. Blaine Keyes will probably be second overall in the points here this season. Both Haas and Keyes finishing in the top 10, which means they both got stage points for the third and final stage of the day. The difference between Haas and Keyes for stage points wise was 4, and Matt Haas gained another 2 there, so 6, and he finished 2 positions ahead of Blaine Keyes, so 8 points difference, it looks like, is going to be the gap from first to second for the completion of this chase. How about that for Matt Haas? What a drive. We talked already about Baskinger. How about the 2-3 finish for the Lincolns out of KAB Racing Enterprises? Keith Batson and Cat Tellier, boy, they are so close to getting that victory, but just the story of their season right there with how they finished out the year, second, third, just so close, but so far. Dylan Young, fourth place run, well-needed run for him. That's going to lock him up a charter for next season. Joseph Srigley, however, this may be his swan song race. He will not have a charter, at least at this point, heading into next season, as he'll finish fifth, but he was outside the top 30 in the points coming into this race without a chance of getting into the top 30 of racing his way in. Sean Henley, he may end up made a case for himself to maybe get that charter that Tweenix Racing currently holds heading into next season as he finishes sixth. Matt Haas will be the champion finishing in seventh. Joshua Michaels, he's got good numbers here at Auto Club. Won at this track 2 seasons ago, gets an eighth place run today. Blaine Keyes brings it home in ninth. What a heartbreak for him. He had to follow Matt Haas across the line knowing his championship hopes were dwindling away with every few feet towards that start-finish line. But he has had a great season nonetheless. And Dallas McIntosh will complete your top 10 here today. Great run for him, even though he didn't make the chase this season. But Sega Motorsports overall had really good team with Dunham, McIntosh, and Blaine Keyes, as seen with their performances this season. Jessica Shelton was en route to a top 10. I really would love to know what happened there, if the car stalled out or what went wrong. But she finishes 11th, 12th for Brandon Gonzalez. Can't call him the defending champion anymore. We'll just call him the former champion. Kyle Matthews finishes 13th, 14th for JT Bryant. And then 15th was Johnny Gardner. Charles Stamper and Anthony McCrory, we didn't really see them after they faded from view midway through the race. They will finish the day out in 17th and 18th in this one. So it looks like it will be the final point stands for the final four. Matt Haas 1, Blaine Keyes 2, Charles Stamper 3, and Anthony McCrory 4. Take a look down through the rest of the finishing results of today's race here. We ended up having 28 cars finish on the lead lap. Problems for Garrett Sidner there on the last lap, but he finishes a lap down along with Carson Gumm, Angel Navarro, and Caleb Farrell finished 4 laps down. And then you see the drivers that all finished out of the race. So that is going to do it for this season here in the Hershey's Cup Series. Matt Haas, the Haasinator, will head into Season 5 as the defending champion of the series. And how ironic is this? Let's just put this into perspective. Only 2 Toyotas came into this season as chartered rides. Emmanuel Hartnett was one. The other was Matt Haas. Talk about defying the odds in a field littered with Fords and Chevys. A Toyota comes out on top with the championship here this season. Thank you all for tuning in to today's race, and thank you for tuning in this entire season. If you enjoyed it, be sure to give this video a like, subscribe to become a part of the crew today. We've shown you your full finish results, and up next, it will be your official rookie standings. Congratulations to Brooke Allen on being the Season 4 Hershey's Cup Series Rookie of the Year, and as well as your overall points and your championship points, as Matt Haas is the Season 4 Hershey's Cup Series champion heading into Season 5. We're going to take a tiny little bit of a break between now and the Tax Slayer Truck Series, Pizza X Series, and Hershey's Cup Series resuming for Seasons 5, 3, and 1. We will be having a special series going on here in the meantime as everything starts to get organized up for the upcoming seasons. Be expecting sign-up videos for both Pizza Hut X Series and Tax Slayer Truck Series very soon. And until then, you've been watching a production of the NSRA Offline Racing at its Best. So long from Season 4 of Hershey's Cup Series Competition.